For joining us tonight at 6, I'm Keith Edwards. Just a few weeks now until the presidential election, and our own McKenna Alexander is breaking down everything you need to know as Eau Claire County prepares for the big vote and some changes that are in the works.
In 2 weeks, voters will decide what's in store for the next 4 years. November 3rd is right around the corner, and as voters prepare to decide who will serve the next presidential term, Eau Claire County is making preparations of its own ahead of what's expected to be a historic voter turnout.
As of Saturday, 26 million Americans had already cast their vote, more than 6 times the amount cast at the same point in the 2016 election. As of Monday, 13,736 ballots have been returned in Eau Claire County of the 21,929 requested, making for a 62.6% return rate, just a little above the state mail-in ballot return rate of 61.4%. So, needless to say, county election officials have been busy.
At the county level, we don't work with the voters, but we do prepare the ballots. We get all the information as far as who needs to be on the ballot, in what order we order the ballots.
In preparation for a voter turnout that's expected to be much higher than this year's previous elections, some changes have been made to drive-through voting in the city of Eau Claire.
We expect the drive-through for city of Eau Claire residents for in-person absentee voting to be busier than it was for August and April. So we have added additional tents so that we can process more voters in a timely fashion.
To accommodate the added tents, South Dewey Street will be temporarily restricted to one-way traffic between Gibson Street and East Grand Avenue during drive-through voting hours.
Voters that live in the city of Eau Claire can use the drive-through service to vote by absentee ballot, return a completed absentee ballot, or register to vote. In Eau Claire for WQOW News 18, I'm McKenna Alexander.
All right, thanks, McKenna. Now, for information on voting times, dates, and directions for navigating the temporary street block-offs into the drive-through site, head to WQOW.com.